बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम। यू आर वाचिंग टू वेटनरी साइंस फॉर यू चैनल विद डॉक्टर मोहम्मद इल्ताफ हुसैन। इफ़ यू आर वाचिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम दिस चैनल, सो सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड क्लिक द बेल आइकन टू रिसीव मोर सच इन्फॉर्मेटिव एंड न्यू वीडियोज रिलेटेड टू वेटनरी एंड एनिमल साइंसेज। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चीज़ मेकिंग। सो अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ चीज़। चीज इज अ जेनेरिक टर्म फॉर अ डाइवर्स ग्रुप ऑफ मिल्क बेस्ड फूड प्रोडक्ट्स। चीज इज प्रोड्यूस्ड थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड इन वाइड रेंजिंग फ्लेवर्स, टेक्सचर्स एंड फॉर्म्स। चीज कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ प्रोटीन्स एंड फैट फ्रॉम मिल्क, यूजुअली द मिल्क ऑफ काउस, बफेलो, गोट्स और शीप। इट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय कोगुलेशन ऑफ द मिल्क प्रोटीन, दैट इज केजीन। ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ चीज मेकिंग। So, to obtain the optimum cheese composition with respect to moisture, acidity, that is pH, fat, protein and minerals, especially calcium. Establish the correct structure of the cheese at the microscopic level and ripen to perfection. Group according to texture and basic manufacturing procedures. There are 7 families of cheese. So, the first step is milk from the evening milking is allowed to stand overnight by natural processes. This milk will have partially separated during its overall standing period. The cream is skimmed off and the partially skimmed milk is combined with the whole milk from the morning milking. The second step is the milk is gradually heated to 30 to 35 degree centigrade before acidification and coagulation. This is the second step. Now after this, the third step, acidification. So starter culture is added to milk to change lactose, milk sugar into lactic acid. This process changes the acidity level of the milk and begins the process of turning milk from a liquid into a solid. This is the third step. And now starter culture. So fermentation starters, called simply starters, within the corresponding context are preparations to assist the beginning of the fermentation process and preparation of various foods and fermented drinks. A starter culture is a microbiological culture which actually performs fermentation. Fourth step, so coagulation. Rennet is added to further encourage the milk to solidify, forming a custard-like mass. Rennet. So what is rennet? It is an enzyme used to coagulate milk during the cheese making process. Rennet is derived from one of 4 sources. The stomach lining of a young calf. The enzyme renin is found in the stomach lining of animals because it aids in the digestion of their mother's milk. Plant, typically thistle. Microbes in fungus and yeast. Genetically engineered rennet that imitates animal rennet. The fourth step is cutting. It's then cut into small pieces to begin the process of separating the liquid whey from the milk solids, that is curds. Large curds are cooked at lower temperatures, yielding softer cheeses like mascarpone and ricotta. Curds cut smaller are cooked at higher temperatures, yielding harder cheeses like Gruyere and Romano. Fifth step is stirring, heating and draining. Cheese makers cook and stir the curds and whey until the desired temperature and firmness of the curd is achieved. The whey is then drained off, leaving a tightly formed curd. The sixth step is salting. Salt adds flavor and also acts as a preservative, so the cheese doesn't spoil during long months or years of aging. It also helps a natural rind to form on the cheese. There are several ways to use salt. Salt can be added directly into the curd as the cheese is being made. The outside of the wheel of cheese can be rubbed with the salt or with a damp cloth that has been soaked in brine. The cheese can also be bought directly in weight of brine. Seventh step is curd transformation. So different handling techniques and salting effect how the curd is transformed into the many cheese varieties made. The eighth step is shaping. The cheese is put into a basket or a mold to form it into a specific shape. During this process, the cheese is also pressed with weights or a machine to expel any remaining liquid. Pressing determines the characteristic shape of the cheese and helps complete the curd formation. Most cheeses are pressed in 3 to 12 hours depending on their size. Step 9. Ripening. Refer to age if in age this process ages cheese until it reaches optimal ripeness. During this process, the temperature and humidity of the cave or room where the cheese ages is closely monitored. For some cheeses, ambient molds in the air give the cheese a distinct flavor. For others, mold is introduced by spraying it on the cheese brie or injecting it into the cheese blue cheese. Some cheeses must be turned, some must be brushed with oil, and some must be washed with brine or alcohol. Aging should take place in a controlled environment. Different cheeses require different temperatures and humidities. However, in a small refrigerator, temperature is kept at 55 degrees Fahrenheit and 85% humidity. During aging, the cheese should be rotated or flipped periodically to prevent moisture from settling in the cheese and to prevent an inconsistent internal consistency. That's all, and thank you so much for watching.